This is how to do a reaction table. Our question reads, complete a reaction table to the nearest 10,000th of a mole for the reaction of 38.52 grams of P4O6 with 38.52 grams of I2. Now, since the gram amounts are the same, you might think, there's no limiting reagent. But that's not the case. Let's write the gram amounts underneath each reactant. 38.52 grams here, and 38.52 grams here. Okay, to find the limiting reactant, we need to figure out which one does the least amount of reaction. So, let me take my 38.52 grams of P4O6 and figure out how many moles that involves. I'll use the atomic weights here to find the molar mass of P4O10, and it is 219.88 grams of P4O6, I'm sorry, that's O6, per one mole of P4O6, and we come up with 0.1752 moles of P4O6. Okay, now I'm going to find out how many times I can do the reaction. I'll do that by dividing it by the coefficient in front of P4O6, which you can see is 5. Okay, so that divided by 5 gives me 0.0350 moles of reaction. That's how many times I can run the reaction. Now let me try the same with the iodine. 38.52 grams of I2, and once again we'll figure out how many moles of that is. So let's see, what is the molar mass of I2? There are 253.8 grams of I2 in one mole of I2. Dividing that out gives us 0.1518 moles of I2. Okay, once again, we'll divide by the coefficient in front of the I2, which is 8, and this tells me that I can run the reaction 0.01898 times, or moles of reaction. Okay, the smaller value right here, it's smaller, so this is going to be my limiting reagent. Okay, limiting reagent means I'm going to use all of it. So let me go back to the table and take my moles of P4O6 and write them in. And my moles of I2 and write them in. And initially, my moles of product are 0. I don't have any yet. All right, the idea of the limiting reagent is that I use all of it. So I'm going to subtract 0.1518 moles of I2 and have nothing left. Now, the other reagents have to base themselves off the limiting reagent. So, to figure out the other amounts, I'm always going to start with the 0.1518 moles of I2. And I notice from the reaction coefficients that for every 8 moles of I2, I consume 5 moles of P4O6. Let me write in the word mole. There we go. So, this gives me a value of 0.0949 moles of P4O6 that I use. I'm going to put a negative sign in front of it because it's reacting 0.0949. Okay, now I just have to do the math. 0.1752 minus 0.0949 gives me 0.0803 moles left over. Alright, let me do the other materials now. Again, I'm going to start with my limiting reagent, 0.1518 moles of I2. Alright, I notice that for every 8 moles of I2, I produce 2 moles of P4I4. All right, let me just take this number, divide by 8, multiply by 2, and we have 0.03795 moles of P4I4. Excellent. Well, I'm going to write that down, and I notice it asks me to just represent things to the 10,000th place there. So I will round up and write that value is 0.0380. Notice that I'm going to have a plus sign in front of it because it's something that is being made. Okay, if I do this math, 0 plus the 0.0380 is, of course, 0.0380. Okay, last one, 0.1518 moles of I2. And in my reaction, for every 8 moles of I2, I produce 3 moles of P4O10, because there's a 3 in front of the P4O10 in the reaction. All right, multiply that out, and it comes out to 0.05693 moles of P4O10. All right, I will put a plus sign in front of that and write 0.0569. Again, I'm going to do it to the 10,000th place. Do the math, and it's 0.0569. Okay, so here's the important thing to notice, all right? We found our limiting reagent. So in the delta row, we used that value, that 0.0518, and put it in the delta row. And for all of the other materials, we based the moles of other materials that we either reacted with or made off the 0.01518 moles of I2. That was our limiting reactant. That's all.